Another episode of Forza Horizon 2. Now today is going to be something a little bit new, and usually sometimes we take out cars for a test drive. That is what I wanted to start doing in Forza Horizon 2, make this a series, and it's kind of be like a progression series. The reason being is that obviously I don't have a lot of money. You guys can see right now $142,000. I'm a little bit broke right now to be going out and dropping, you know, 100K on a car. So I figured we'd start the series out nice and cheap with the first gen Type R. And I mean, we get a lot of value for our actual money. So $9,000 we're going to be putting into this car. And we're going to be getting back a B16 right now, 1.6 with an LSD transmission. I can't go wrong with that, man. We got the red bucket. Doesn't even have the red buckets. Are you serious? I thought for sure that thing would have had the red buckets on there, man. I don't know about that. We have no red interior whatsoever. This is the 97 model, not the 98, if I'm not mistaken, right? Let me just double check here. Even the 98 model came with the red buckets still. Just lost a lot of the extras. But let's see here. Just go back, man. Yeah, it is the 97. Where's our damn red Recaros then? Oh my god, dude. Slacking on that. Just a little bit. Now we're gonna see what designs we can pick up on here. I'm hoping we have some really nice ones. I'd love to see some, you know, clean ones, maybe a couple moving ones, hopefully. You never know. You know, today would be great though, you know what I'm saying? Oh my god. Alright, so for whatever reason, the paint shop is down. I know the game's been taking a hard hit online lately, so we're gonna pick this up. $9,000 right now, and we just earned one of probably the best damn cars in the game. Not literally now. Come on, guys. I can already see the damn haters coming out. I see you guys. Get your ass back inside, man. So, what we're going to be doing, as I said, just going for a cruise, man. Really just having fun with this car, exploring a little bit, and seeing where we're going to go. So, we got to pull up this damn map right now. Let's see. Now, we do have a barn find up here, so I can really do two birds with one stone on this and nail this barn find as I'm kind of testing out this car and maybe going through and hitting a couple things as we go. So that's what we're going to do right now, and we're going to have some fun with this, man. This car should be dope. Let's have a little bit of a listen. Okay, so we're going to just get out of this loud area a little bit. I know it's probably not the easiest for you guys to hear anything right now. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, so here we are. We're just going to cruise right now, man. We're going to try and stay within the speed limit. Keep it realistic, at least. We're not going to try and break too many damn stop signs or anything like that. But I would like to maybe try and find a couple people to race and really kind of push this car to its limits, say, and really kind of get a good I guess review for this car. So I do see off in the distance that man up there has that damn gold credit marker on him. We're gonna go take his ass out. Hopefully our stock B series can take him out. Look at this car coming out of the damn woodwork. Jesus. All right just cruising with him. S15 versus the Type R. It's got us, man. We have about 197 horsepower coming out of this thing. Oh! Handling is nice, though. We're not going to follow him. We're not about that life today, man. Try and keep it clean. Brakes feel really good though, but coming through that last section right there, I mean, the handling was really nice. I mean, yes, we got a little bit shaky, but I mean, overall though, we came to a stop, nobody got hurt, we're good, man. We're gonna do a couple of pulls on third to fourth gear, but I would like to try and find somebody to race against though, and there's a pack right there. Here we go. Takeover Trio. I got you, my man. We're not letting this guy get out of here in that beat-up.
Come in.
We're gonna damn race up right here. Here we go. The Corrado. Let's get it, man. This thing's gonna go.
400 yards. Turn.
Here we go.
Right.
We got this, man. There's no way he's taking us. Where's my VTEC at?
Turn right. At the roundabout,
oh.
Take the second exit.
We're actually gonna do the roundabout. We're gonna try it now. Looks like he got taken out back there. I don't know what happened, but looks like that roundabout, he was not about that damn life right there. My knee's itchy. There we go. There we go. Just keep it nice and controlled right here. We got a lot. Oh, shit. I thought that he was actually a lot farther away than that.
Oh, my God.
0.7 miles. We got him. Come on now. Where's my VTEC? Pull, man. Let's get it. That was dope.
Pay attention to the difficulty rating of festival racers before you challenge them.
That was
them.
Insane.
Higher difficulty ratings mean bigger payouts.
Oh, I know, girl. Jeez. That fifth gear pull, though, was real, man. That was insane. So that is why I like this series, though, as well, too, is because, really, you don't get to drive a lot of these cars stock. You don't get to see what the cars, you know, actual power, actual weight, actual handling of it. And you know, when we're doing all these builds, we're really just throwing in the best possible parts from the factory, or you know, anything else for that matter, just throwing it in there and making, you know, an overpowered car. So it's nice sometimes just to kind of take it for what it is. We're driving on damn, well, what the hell are we doing back here, man? I don't remember this. There's some bullshit right here. Damn beautiful damn Civic getting all day and gravel everywhere. Now, one thing before we head out for today's video was, one big thing actually, was I was going to do the CRX for the first episode, and I don't know why, oh, we got a bug right there? What? What do you think? Should we take the transit van on? Oh, man, you know what? I don't know. Oh, yeah, Lamborghini or transit van? Lamborghini is not happening right here. Here we go. Ford Super Sport van. Let's get it.
In 100 yards.
We got him on the cornering for sure. Oh, shit. I did not know it was that left. Let's go, let's go. I thought it was way farther down.
In 400 yards, turn sharp left.
I got you, girl. Oh! He didn't even go
turn
with the damn thing. I ain't turning around,
so.
Anna.
Recalculating route in 400
Look at
yards.
This. Pull it on him right now,
right.
Man. We can just cruise with him, really. We got time. Where's he going? What are you doing, transit man? Oh, my God. Queek. How kind of name is that?
In 200 yards.
All right, buddy.
Right.
You take care, my man.
Turn right.
Jeez. We're just going to go ahead and finish this off. But yeah, the CRX was $55,000. Somebody explain that to me, please. Oh, shit. Coming too hot off of there. But yeah, the CRX was $55,000. I don't understand it. Please, somebody have a logical answer at the bottom, because I can't think of one right now. So, I mean, they really did up that price. I don't know if they know that I like CRXs, and they're like, oh, let's just screw the slack train, you know what I'm saying? But I'm just messing with you. But no, I mean, I don't understand why it's so high. There's a couple of other cars as well, too, that are very high priced that shouldn't be. So hopefully they fix that in a patch. And yeah, we can get our CRX for like 15K or whatever it was before, man. Ridiculous. Now we're coming through the last two gears right now of this damn cruise. Overall, I really enjoyed this car. As I said, the big thing was the pull. That fifth gear pull was real. It was really nice. And overall, the handling was nice. Braked very easily. Tell me that's him. Are you serious? Did he just beat us over here? No way. Oh my god, man. I gotta look back at that and see what exactly just happened. If I lost that, that is gonna be too damn funny. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys very much for coming around today. If you guys did enjoy this episode test driving the 97 Civic Type R, slap the damn like button, man. I mean, you guys already should have slapped it for just driving a B16 for today. But other than that, guys, make sure you guys follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all of which are in the description box below as well. Team Slap on Forza Horizon 2, you guys are welcome to join it. It is an open crew, so get in here before all those 1,000 spots become full. So thank you guys very much for watching today. It's your boy, Slap Train. I'm out. Peace. Don't burn me down.